is Tripura, strategic part of easternmost frontier of our defense forces. In this episode of Special Report, we'll take a closer look into the deployment of BSF in this easternmost point of our nation and would see firsthand how different and difficult it is to man and maintain the international border which is adjoining Bangladesh. We grew up with fond memories of creation of Bangladesh in 1971, highlighting one of the most glorious chapters in military histories of all times, when almost about 1 lakh Pakistani armed forces were brought to their knees. Overnight, a new nation was created with a brand new markings on the world map, and this brought in a new and complex situation in the Indian subcontinent. With fast-changing political scene in Bangladesh after Sheikh Mujibur Rahman's assassination on 15th August 1975, tension in guarding a friendly neighborhood has always been a challenging task. And to do the needful, this delicate task to maintain peace and secure the border lines along the newly created Bangladesh, big time movement of BSF, the Border Security Force, took place. They were immediately deployed and positioned along the eastern frontier after the 71 war. Their garrison headquarters, erstwhile Calcutta. To do an on-the-spot assessment of deployment of border security force in the Eastern Theatre of War Games, Rajya Sabha TV crew went straight inside into the deepest parts of Tripura. Trekked along the fences, during the day as well as in the pitch darkness, took stock of situation of river changing its course, resulting in a bitter clash of interest between India and Bangladesh, and saw for the first time how troops are performing their duties in the deadly malaria-infected jungles, right on the edge of the eastern frontier of India's map. A whopping stretch of 4,096 kilometers is India's international border with Bangladesh. And speaking of facts, almost 85% of the boundary of the state of Tripura is classified as an international border. No other state in the Union of India is surrounded from three sides by an international border. These fortified fences are actually erected on Indian territory, few hundred meters from the actual marking on the ground. Both Pakistan and Bangladesh do not have such barriers on their sides. Protecting their borders, it appears, is not their prime objective at the borderline. On the Western front, anyone breaching through these concertina wires is rewarded in cash and kind in Pakistan. On the Eastern front, the situation is different. There are patches where local community lives right on the zero line, and the threat perception here in eastern sector is different.
in the eastern side, it is very underdeveloped. And the problem for the BSF has increased because with the coming of the border fence close to the border. Earlier, the BOPs were in the rear areas. Now, we are having a border fence which is running very close to the border. So, as a result of that, our BOPs which were earlier there in the eastern side, we are shifting all those BOPs close to the border. So, we are now, as of now, besides guarding the border, we are also providing security to all the construction agencies which are involved in the construction of border fence and border roads.
Terrain in Tripura is exactly opposite to what it is, per se, in the great run of Kutch in Gujarat. BSF here in Tripura is at loggerheads. It is not only fighting against, with its barrel of gun pointing to somewhat still active militant organization, the outlawed National Liberation Front of Tripura, the NFLT, but is fighting against the worst enemy, the rugged terrain. The probability of no roads is overbearing all over the eastern side of the map of India. Almost the entire international boundary with Bangladesh is clearly earmarked. There are many locations where local population lives very, very close to their counterparts in Bangladesh.
This is River Feni, which flows deep inside the thick jungles of Tripura. It flows into Bangladesh. Everything seems to be okay in this picture till this moment. But the dicey problem for BSF is about 70 kilometers of its stretch is demarcated as the international boundary between India and Bangladesh. River, that too has international border, is always difficult to man and maintain.
Border management at this location is peaceful in military terms, but is volatile in terms of smuggling across this water channel. BSF has deployed a fleet of its speedboats to check miscreants and unwarranted crossings. Children apart, who sometimes try to cross this stream and when spotted, they are promptly asked to swim back to Bangladesh.
That is River Gumti, that is just behind me, and River Kakri, which is around 2 kilometers from here. Other than manning and dominating the land borders, we have to dominate and restrict curbs smuggling from this riverine border as well.
Not many in the outside world know that Agartala Airport is located almost on the zero line, very, very close to the actual international border between India and Bangladesh. Border pillars are nearly touching the airstrip. Commercial flights landing at this remote facility fly almost all the time over Bangladesh and would enter into Indian airspace only for a couple of seconds before the touchdown. Border fence here is at the tricky point. It's patrolled 24/7, even in the dead of the night.
हमारा मेन मुद्दा यही है कि हम अपना ड्यूटी पूरा मुस्तैदी के साथ करते हैं और कोई भी गैरकानूनी आदमी इंडिया से ना बांग्लादेश में जाए ना बांग्लादेश से इंडिया में आए. हम इस बॉर्डर को पूरी तरह सील करके रखते हैं.
ये यस बिल्कुल, एयरपोर्ट बिल्कुल नज़दीक है और आप देखेंगे इधर सामने एयरपोर्ट की दीवार है, बहुत ही नज़दीक है जो कि ऑलमोस्ट 150 गज़ के आसपास ही है। ये अपना जो एयरपोर्ट है ये वर्ल्ड वार सेकंड 1942 का ये बना हुआ है, बिल्कुल इसके बाद ये रिड्रा हुई है और जैसा ये पिलर्स है, पिलर्स का जो अपना एरिया, हम इसमें पूरा एयरपोर्ट के नज़दीक होने की वजह से हम इसको बहुत ही अच्छे तरीके से मुस्तैदी से डोमिनेट करते हैं। काउंटर पार्ट जो बांग्लादेश बॉर्डर गार्ड है उनके साथ जो हमारे रिश्ते हैं बहुत अच्छे हैं।
They come together with you to do joint patrolling?
Yes, बिल्कुल, सप्ताह में एक बार प्लाटून कमांडर मिलते हैं और 15 दिन में एक बार कंपनी कमांडर और इंस्ट्रक्शन के हिसाब से हमें कमांडेंट को भी मंथ में एक बार मिलना होता है और हम रेगुलर मिलते हैं, मीटिंग करते हैं, ज्वाइंट पेट्रोलिंग करते हैं और बहुत ही मुस्तैदी के साथ अपने एरिया को हम डोमिनेट करते हैं।
Forest here in Tripura is dense and green, not the likes of which we see in Chhattisgarh, where visibility inside forest improves once tree leaves fall on the ground during the autumn break. The eastern flank does not provide any such luxury to BSF. Jungle in Tripura is thick and green throughout the year. Visibility is poor, it's densely packed. Troops have to battle with leeches during 8 months of rainy season. And the super deadly PB malaria, the Plasmodium falciparum malaria, is widespread. Such pictures appears to be taken straight out of from some battle formations from the ancient Roman times. Body gear leaving no exposed part, headgear covered with wire mesh or believe it or not with malaria net. And this is not the end. Each soldier has to carry a canister full of kachua chhap agarbattis or any other thing that would make smoke, all in an attempt to keep away malaria insects. Life is tough for these BSF troopers.
While keeping the primary duty, the primary mandate of the BSF to guard the Indo-Bangladesh and Indo-Pakistan border, the degree of difficulties and the duties can be categorized into two ways. One, the difficulties in terms of geographical features and the difficulty in terms of the challenges that are posed by different two borders, because the challenges on these two borders are quite different.
All this was not done for RSTV cameras, we were told. This is a matter of routine, day in and day out, for these hardy BSF soldiers who are keeping our borders safe so that each and every Indian can sleep well in the night.
We take a short break and when we come back, we will focus on a controversial issue of river changing its course and altering international border, which had resulted dispute between India and Bangladesh and the role of the BSF. Welcome back from the break. We are deep inside the remote corner in Tripura along with BSF deployment. There has been a clash point between India and Bangladesh on this location next to the Mohri River. As and when this Mohri River, which is adjoining Bilonia town, would change its course, the international boundary would be redrawn between India and Bangladesh, and that is a clash point, that is a controversy. Location is Bilonia on the southeastern side of Tripura, and the dispute is known as Charmuri land dispute. During the past 50 years, this river Mohri has changed course as many as 4 times. As per the international accepted norms, if the boundary between two nations is demarcated by a river or a stream,
The middle or the deepest part of the channel is taken as the zero line, the exact territorial boundary between two nations as clearly marked. Each time when Ria Mohri changed its course, IB changed. Indian government agreed, but the government of Bangladesh did not. The body of matter in question is the ownership of land vacated by Ria Mohri whenever it changed course. The land is very fertile in this part of Tripura, in fact quite productive. And there lies the problem. Whose land is it when river changes its course?
मुहरी रिवर ये पिछले 60-65 साल में करीब चार बार अपना कोर्स चेंज कर चुकी है, जिसकी वजह से ये डिस्प्यूटेड लैंड जो है अकर हुई है, काफ़ी हिस्सा चेंज हुआ है ये, क्योंकि चार बार इसने चेंज किया है तो इसमें जो है टोटल 62.27 एकड़ लैंड करीब जो है वो इमर्ज हुई है, और जिसमें कि जो पुराना कोर्स था 1893 का कोर्स था उसको लें और अब अगर हम अभी प्रेजेंट कोर्स को लें तो इसके बीच में जो है वो टोटल 62.27 एकड़ की जो लैंड है वो इमर्ज हुई है, और ये टोटल लैंड की जो लेंथ है वो टोटल 1.6 किलोमीटर की लेंथ है।
After prolonged negotiations and stormy sessions between India and Bangladesh, an agreement has been reached. Earlier this year, BSF along with Survey of India officials conducted a thorough examination and stated that course of this river as it was in 1893 should be final marking of the boundary between the two nations. On the ground, that appears to be a difficult task. Temporary border pillars have been erected by a border security force. These flags are quite deep inside the Indian territory. A new marking of international boundary, not yet formalized, but the BSF has a delicate task to maintain peace and order as local population in Bilonia is becoming quite restive by each passing day. They are about to lose their ownership rights of large fields and state government is yet to offer them a good package. BSF, on its part, is keeping a close watch on the situation.
Appreciated that how difficult it is and yet how well we are managing it. Tripura poses a altogether different challenge. Part of Mizoram poses altogether different challenge. The very high hill tracks are there, where the road have not been constructed so far. We have many air maintained BOPs, where you can't go on foot. All the supplies and order item arrangements are made through choppers. Since we have the air support, so we are able to sustain and maintain those posts.
Despite the Char Mohri land dispute, a successful and peaceful venture has taken shape between the two nations. Modeled on the lines of Delhi-Lahore bus service, the Agartala-Akhaura bus service has brought tons of peace across the tense fence. For daily passengers or even first-timers, this bus service is run under the protective umbrella of the Border Security Force. This is his first bus ride across the border.
People are getting benefited. because you know the two countries is very close to each other. Not only the geographical condition is very close, but also we culturally and linguistically we are very close.
The local BSF commandant has a delegate task to oversee the bus ride and also keep a hawk eye on the commercial traffic flying across the border. The retreat ceremony at the border checkpost Agartala Akhora is nowhere near to the pomp and show at Atari Wagha border on the Western Front. Ever since battalion number 195 took position at this checkpoint Charlie, a small beginning has been made to mark the retreat and lowering of flags on both sides of the fence. Militancy in Tripura is still active. There were at least dozen outlawed outfits operating in the past. One band organization, the National Liberation Front of Tripura, is still somewhat active. Within 2 days of our visit to this remote region, this band organization have shot and killed one BSF trooper along with one local resident. In fact, our visit to Chittagong Hill Tracks area was rescheduled at the last moment after two local boys were kidnapped by the outlawed organization. We were told they had returned after local villagers reportedly paid the National Liberation Front of Tripura some ransom. This is Chittagong Hill Tracks area, high in the mountains in East Tripura. The growing problem here is militancy, dominated by the banned and outlawed National Liberation Front of Tripura. The job for BSF is not only to prevent militants entering into India, but to safeguard the international border with Bangladesh. The story of militancy connected to NLFT in Tripura goes like this. Its active or inactiveness is somewhat directly proportional to who is leading Bangladesh. If Sheikh Hasina is in power in Dhaka, then NLFT behaves differently. And when Khalida Zia is there at the top of power struggle in Bangladesh, this banned organization assumes a totally different role. Remote and inaccessible location gives outlawed organization natural cover. As said earlier, roads are remote and difficult to maintain in many parts of this area. Some have been carved out, slicing through dense jungle. Tracks difficult to drive, even on full power four wheels. Only BSF troopers know how to conquer this enemy. The visiting RSTV had a very close share with destiny. We were in the last vehicle of the convoy, busy in filming an interesting sequence while returning from a jungle patrol with a BSF platoon. The time was just around 6:15 p.m. in the evening. In Delhi, 6:15 during evening hours is pretty bright, but here in the northeast, it was pitched dark. Our four-wheel drive broke down and began to skid backwards on a steep 40-degree slope. By the time we realized what had happened, we were stranded in the middle of extremely dense jungle packed with PB malaria insects and reportedly close to the vicinity of NLFT hideouts.
बहुत खराब है
सर, बहुत खराब
है। लोग आगे गए हुए हैं, आप कैसे उनको सूचना कैसे दी जाए?
हम लोग फंस जाएंगे बिल्कुल।
नहीं सर, आएंगे अभी, कोई साधन नहीं है। कम
आप हमारे साथ रहिए, हम लोग जंगल में इस समय अकेले हैं।
ठीक है सर, अपना
बारूद है ना?
हाँ सर, पूरा सर।
कोई मिलिटेंट आ जाएगा तो मुकाबला?
हाँ सर, हम करेंगे।
ठीक है, ठीक है।
The young BSF commander who was leading the charge soon realized what had happened and promptly dispatched a rescue team. We kept the headlights of our vehicle switched on, hoping someone would see us from a distance. But the treacherous mountain terrain kept high beams blocked till the rescue party came quite close to us. Those stranded 20 minutes in Tripura's jungles were like never ending. A real close shave.
Dheere sir, aram se, we are safe now. Thank God. गाड़ी जो है उसमें फोर व्हील लग नहीं रहा है और पीछे पीछे की तरफ खिसक रही है।
Soon after this incident, RSTV crew was promptly removed from the hypersensitive areas and taken to some safe locations, far away from striking range of outlawed militants. This was a special report on the BSF deployment in the far east corners of the country, one of the most difficult areas which are inaccessible and remote. BSF here is truly performing a stellar role, which is rightly known as the first line of defense. With my cameraman colleagues Dushmant and MS Suresh, this is Vineet Dikshit for the special report on BSF in Tripura. In our next and continuing episode on Border Security Force, we take a rare look into the BSF's operation at the Western Theatre in Gujarat. Hitherto unknown scene footage of Run of Kutch, Sir Creek and many other locations only on Rajya Sabha Television.